Hey guys, it's Julie Sinner back here for another high intensity interval workout, HIIT. And we're doing my favorite 45 second intervals, 15 second rest. We're gonna alternate between plyometric high intensity cardio and strength. And some of them mix it up. We have 18 moves. We're gonna go through them twice with a minute 15 break in the middle. We're gonna start with a warm up and do it pretty quick, and we'll end with a cool down. So if you only have time for like say 25 minutes, 30 minutes, do the warm up, do one cycle of the 18 moves, and then cool it off, stretch it out, and you're good to go. And you can get it done in 25 minutes. Otherwise, stick with me for the whole time. We're gonna go through it twice. We'll alternate sides the second time through if there's a one-sided move. And otherwise, just make it happen. All right, guys, so we're gonna start warming it up. We're gonna reach and pull, bring the knee up, cross the elbow. But the knee doesn't come across, just straight up. The arm comes across and you're twisting through the middle. I'm gonna lift the knee all the way up. Step lightly. Give me 8 more. A little bigger twist. Be very intentional. Bringing the shoulder forward. Yes. All right, let's take that arms out. Take a nice sturdy stance. We're gonna squat and then tuck lunge back. So we're gonna squat, lunge back, squat, and up. Squat, lunge back. Sit down low in your squat. Arms just floating by your side, getting them warm, just by having them raised. At the top, I want you to squeeze your buns together. Stay low, stay low, low, then up. This time we're gonna change it to a front lunge, pulse for 3. Step it out, pulse at 3. Step together, pulse it back, 3. Together, same leg. Two more on this side, then we switch. Now, on the lunge, I want you to drop the back knee as low as you can, keeping it nice and tall and upright through the torso. Other leg, step it forward, pulse it. Think about pulsing the knee down. Nice, broad chest. Shoulders are relaxed. Even though the arms are raised, get your shoulders nice and relaxed. One more time on this leg. You should start feeling nice and toasty through the legs. And take it up. We're gonna take it to some plank moves to get the core and the arms nice and warm. So we want you to have a mat. We also have, I have one set of 8-pound weights. So you might wanna grab some weights for later. We're gonna need them. If you don't have them, just do the moves without it. All right, let's take a deep breath in. Forward fold, half lift. Now we're gonna walk those hands out to plank. Freeze your plank, tuck your pelvis, bring your shoulder blades together. Get your chest forward. Your shoulders are just above your wrists. Walk your feet in to a pike, a nice tall pike. We're just gonna do a little glute lift, lifting alternating legs. We've got the ears between the biceps. Four more. Now this is the pike position you'll see later. Just hold it here. We're gonna do push-ups in this position later where we drop the top of our head to the mat. Walk those feet back to your plank because in that same move, we're gonna jump between plank and pike. When you walk your hands back to your feet. Roll it up. Do it again, roll it down. Walk those hands out to plank. Hold your plank. We're gonna scissor the legs. Bring one leg under, reach the top arm, hand down, take that foot back. Other side, scissor the legs, extend the shoulders back and back, nice and slow. Underneath, reach down, set it down, keep that plank warm. Give me one more each side. Underneath, raise it up nice and tall. Last one. Down, back, walk your hands back to your feet. Keep that stiff plank. Roll it up. Good job, you should be nice and warm now. Through shoulders, chest, upper back, legs, everything's going. We're gonna start with a lunge pulse for four, then we step together and switch sides. Now, I'm gonna add a little hop in between, and then hop the feet together and switch sides. You can leave it at just a back lunge. The rest will cue as we get there. We're gonna do 45 seconds on, 15 seconds off, like I said. You're gonna give me a second to set the timer. We'll come back and get started. All right, get ready to start. We're gonna wait for that whistle. Then we're going to do that jump lunge for four. I'm gonna add a little pulse hop to it, then together and switch sides. Up to you if you want to add that pulse. Three, four, three, two, one, together. Do what you want with your arms. You need a little balance. Run them here. Whatever works. Now, the hop is super light. You're using your core to support the movement. Nice and tall. Notice how I'm not leaning forward in the lunge. Now the option, of course, is to just step it back and pulse it. Step it in and other side. Four, three, two, one, together. Great, grab your weights. We're going to a back lunge, overhead press, to a lat pull, tipping it over to warrior three. Get your weights ready. Okay, right leg back, overhead press. You're gonna pull down, upper arms towards the center, push off, lift that back leg, lift into a reverse fly. Take it down, overhead, pull down like you're using a lat machine. Lift, squeeze from the glute, squeeze those shoulder blades together. We really wanna get in the upper back here. So I want you to slide those shoulder blades together as if you're shutting sliding glass doors. Take it up, tip it over. If you need that extra stability, you leave that foot down. You just don't tip over as much. Good. All right, we're gonna do a burpee to a push-up. Then we're gonna hop to that pike push-up, hop back to the plank push-up, then take the feet in and out. All right, here we go. Down, out, push up. Hike it up to a pike push up. Back to a plank push up. Feet in, vertical jump. Down, out. Pop those feet in. Out. Yep. Now your option is to step it back, drop the knees, push up. Walk the knees in, keep the knees bent. Push up, walk them back out. And step them in, rise up to your toes. Those are your options. Nice job. Okay. Plie squat hops for two, turn to a lunge for two. These are pretty simple. We'll start without the hops. Wide stance. Tuck the pelvis, pretend like you're pressing your back against a wall. Turn for two, center. You're gonna pivot on the back toe. So it's a plie, pivot to a lunge. Now, let's add a little hop, just like we did with that first move. Barely leaving the ground, so very low impact for a plyometric move. Two, with me. Good. You can always leave the hops out of that one if you need to. We're gonna do high-low plank jacks. Here we go. High-low plank jack. Plank jack. Low. Plank jack. High. Low. Now we're going to the beat. You don't need to go this fast. You can also take it to your knees and just extend the legs instead of jumping. Feel that through your shoulders, I hope. All right, we're gonna plie, we're gonna crab walk. Now, the tricep dips. What do? On the heels of your hands, hips lifted, crawl it back. Now, keep the hips up, bend the elbows. Don't drop the hips, just sink low by bending the elbows. Walk it forward, bend the elbows. Keep the wrists under the shoulders. Two more. Keep your spine long. 8, 7, 6. Bend the elbows. Little dips. Walk it. Bend the elbows. Stay strong. Almost there. Now let's send triceps in the back of the shoulder. There you go. All right. We have, we're gonna straddle hop up the board, up the mat. Then we're gonna do 180. Allow me to demonstrate. Right here, straddle hop. Get to the top, turn it around. Really sink low in your squat. Sink low. If you need to, you can walk this. What do I mean? Yes? Good. Ooh, I'm dizzy. All right. We are squat kicking to the side. And then we're stepping onto a side squat and then kicking three. Let's go. Step out, kick, 2, 3. Squat. Notice how my heel and my knee are at the same place. 4, down. 4. I lied. 3. We had to get on the beat there. Down and up. Sit low on the squat before you step it in. Step out, step in, and kick. Out and in. Now your hips have started to work already in those lunges and squats. So you should start to feel this in the medial glute right here. Good. We'll do the other leg the next time through. So, plank tuck to plank ski. This one's tough, okay? I'll show you options. We got tuck to one side, tuck center to the other side. Okay, keep flat through the back. Your option is just knee, knee, and then elbow, elbow. Yes? And sit back in child's pose whenever you need a break. All right, this is only 45 seconds. Ooh, just in the nick of time, right? That's a tough one. Okay, we're gonna grab some weights. You're gonna go into a chair pose. Stand it up, roll the shoulders down and back. Sit your hips low. Now, bring our weights to the shoulders. We're gonna press out and in while coming up to our toes. Now, you don't have to add the toes. You can stay flat-footed here. I want you to glide. That's the pigs. You hear that? They're saying hi. I'm gonna sink a little lower. I was up a little high. Guinea pigs, that is. That's what they are. Our little piggies. Cinnamon sugar. Down, down. Out, out. Almost there. Try to keep your torso perfectly still there. Okay, we're gonna do a Heisman. So, high knees for three and then you freeze it. Watch me. One, two, three. You wanna really hike the knee up. Crunch forward and freeze. We're running laterally, side to side. Now let's pick up the knees a little bit more. Freeze. Freeze, remember the Heisman? Almost there. Good. Seems easy at the first. Okay, we got a falling push-up. You're gonna stay low. You're gonna squat low, and you're gonna be brave and launch yourself forward. So I'm low, and I'm launching forward into a push-up, walking my hands back. Now, your option here is, of course, just do regular push-ups, either on your toes or your knees. Either way, hips stay low. Don't hinge at the hips. And let your chest come down. There you go. All right, triple burpee. So we're gonna go down, out with the feet, in, out, in, and up. You guys got this. Let's go. In, up. Okay, if you just widen the knees a little bit, I find it a little easier. In, out. In, up. Close enough. Call on that one. Right, cobra push-up, take it all the way to the belly. You're just going to leave the hips on the ground. Sorry about that. Leave your hips on the ground. Hands right next to the chest, push it up two, and down. Dig it up, leave the thighs on the mat. Just lift the chest, we'll press into the heels of the hand, lift high. You don't have to straighten the arms. I can't. I don't have that kind of back flexibility. If you do, go for it. But it's not necessary here. Try to relax the shoulders away from the ears. Squeeze your glutes. Ooh. Oh. That is really good for the triceps. and a much easier positioning to kind of get and master. Okay, we're gonna do a power jack to a plank jack. A lot of these moves kind of look similar to one another. We're gonna jack it here, or power, take it down, and jack. Be light on your feet here. Give me that burst, plyometric burst. That's propulsion, and that's what plyometrics is all about. How much we got left? Three more ones left. Okay, we're going to a plank. We're going to do a row to kick back, one each side, no push-up, then step it in, and overhead press. Get on your weights. So, row, kick back, keep your hips flat, row, kick back, step it in, overhead press. Take it down and back, row, kick back, row, kick back, step it in, sit low, press overhead, take it down and back, row, kick it. Sit low. That part's hard. Much harder than it looks. All right, put your weights aside. We're gonna take it to a low side plank. On one side, we're staying on one side the whole time. So, on your elbow, you're gonna straighten those legs, lift the hips, hand behind the head. You're gonna crunch forward. And dip it. Crunch. Dip. Keep it strong. Nice and stiff through the core. Don't hinge at the hips here. You're twisting through your abdomen, not your hips. Do the other side next time through. One more. There you go. All right, last move. Three level bird dog. I absolutely love this move. You're reaching opposite arm and leg. You don't have to be in full plank. You can drop those knees to the ground and still do the extension. Let's go. Opposite. Take it halfway down, same thing. Now all the way down, and the same reach. Squeezing through the glutes. Hands next to the chest, push it up. Take it to the other side. Take it down. All the way. Squeeze the glutes. Levitate up. One, or the first time through, that is our minute 15 break. We're gonna start from the top. All right, I get it. I know these are tough. I'm huffing and puffing, I'm feeling tired, but I know I got 18 moves left. That's it. Then we cool down. That's 18 minutes, and you're gonna get way more done doing these moves for 18 minutes than you would at the gym doing 45 minutes of steady state. I promise you, this is gonna burn more calories, build muscle, and build up your metabolism faster than regular old steady state, bike, walking, jogging type thing. Not that there isn't value in those. There's lots of value in that. We're not gonna do this time, okay. Ready? We're gonna do a little pulse lunge, this time starting with the left leg forward and we're gonna pull this for four. Let's go, four, three, two, one, together. Now it's really easy to kind of half do this, but I don't want you to do that. I want you to get low and give me a little bounciness in your step. Down, up, down, up, down, up, together. Down, together, gotta get on that beat. Good, good. Ooh. Nose is already starting to run. That's how you know it's really intense, yes? Good. All right, we're done with those for the day. At least I am. We're gonna grab the weights, step to a back lunge, press overhead. So, left leg goes back, overhead. Left leg goes back, pull, drop, lift that leg, squeeze the shoulder blades together. Give it a little second there. Drop the knee. Reverse, squeeze. Give that contraction a second to register in your brain. Yes, squeeze that glute. That's gonna help you balance. Sink the back knee. Press while you push the shoulders away from your ear. Good. Okay. Burpee and push up. Jump to pike. Yada yada. You know the drill. Let's do it. Down out. Push up. Pike. Push up. Plank. Push up. Take it in. Vertical jump. Or we can walk those feet. You can drop the knees if you need to right here. You can bend the knees here. See? See, dropping the knees is a little bit easier. Take it in. Strong in that one. Okay, we're gonna plie squat for two, then we're gonna pivot to a lunge hop for two. I'm gonna add the hops right away. Now I'm staying on this beat. It's kind of slow, making me feel a little heavy. So I'm gonna speed up a little bit. Now, you don't have to add that hop. You can just be here, still pivoting on that back foot. Keep the knee safe. Rotate, rotate. Almost there. Over. Okay, high low plank jacks. High plank, low plank. You can tap the foot instead of jacking it. Try to get rid of the hunchback. This is what happens. This is what you want. Down. Getting tired. Oh, I think my staff timer stopped again. Oh, let's check it out. Hold on. All right, moving on. Crab walks with dips. All right, get your mat long. Lift the chest. Straighten up the neck. Four, three. If you can, keep the hips lifted. The option is to drop the hips on the ground right here and press through the heels of the hand. You'll still get a great workout through the triceps. But that's preferable to doing this. Watch my arms. They're not bending. I'm just bobbing my hips. That's no good. You're not getting the work done in the triceps. That's the point of this movement. Why bother doing it wrong? Three, four. A couple more. Good. Okay. We've got plank tuck. No, side squat. To a side leg. Side kick. We're squatting it out, kicking the other side. Three, two, one. Three, two, one. This is a lot easier when I wasn't already exhausted, right? Keep that leg hiked up high, like a fire hydrant. Keep that foot in line on the same plane. Three, two, one, step down. You're stepping on and in with the other foot. Step out, step in, kick. Challenge of the balance, especially when you're tired, is really good and really hard. Okay, we're gonna do that chair pose. No, plank tuck. I'm skipping ahead. I must feel tired. Plank tuck, ski, tuck, ski, tuck. Right about now is when you want to start to give up, but you only have few moves left. Let's power through together. Oh, that was a tease. Okay, chair pose, stand it up. We're gonna sit the hips down, weights at the chest. Now, press out and in. Now we're keeping still with that torso. Very challenging after all that high intensity work. Extend and in. Make the weights just float. Loosen your grip. Stay low with the hips. I'm gonna go a little lower. Challenge the quads. Coming up onto those tippy toes. Really focuses on those quadriceps. Good, good. One more. Good. All right. Heisman. Knee high, okay? Do yourself a salad. Get ready. I'm gonna go a little faster. I'm gonna keep building. You don't need to go this fast. Take it to your own needs for the day. Not ability, but needs. Right? You might be sore from a run yesterday, and this is going to be more challenging today. So just do what you need to do to get out of it the most you can. Lift that knee. line push-up. Remember to keep the hips low. Now your option, of course, is those regular push-ups. You can go on your knees. Now you don't have to come straight. See, I came with my knees bent. Or you can come all the way forward and walk back. Up to you. You gotta be brave. Your arms will catch you. Even if maybe you bumped your nose on the mat. Triple burpee. Challenging. You can walk it out on this burpee. You don't need to jump it off. Three, two, one. Otherwise, you're down here. Knee in. Step it in. Press it up. That one. That's actually one of the goals, to intensify to the point where you cannot breathe. Okay, we're doing that cobra push-up. Get down. Press with the hands. Elbows are tight to your side. Squeeze your glutes. Lower your shoulders. Feet up just for a couple. Feet up and down. Two more. Whew. Amazing how much you feel those, right? Okay, we got a power jack to a plank jack. And then we have three moves left, that's it. Now I can do a regular jack. I can step it out, tap it up. Or, buzzer half a second early. Oh, I hope you do too. Okay, plank with row kick back each side and then step it in to your sumo. Here we go. Row and kick back. Right, left, step it in, sit super low, overhead press. Now, here's what we want to avoid. Kicking the hip up like that. No, keep it flat. Lift, extend. That's all core. Just keeping that position is a ton of core. Spread your feet apart and behind you. Give them a little straddle. That will help broaden your base of support. Make it a little easier to stabilize the hips. Overhead. straight. Low side plank, forward crunch to a hip dip. Come on. Dip. Keep it strong. Nice and stiff through the core. Don't hinge at the hips here. You're twisting through your abdomen, not your hips. We'll do the other side next time through. One more. There you go. All right, last move. Three level bird dog. I absolutely love this move. You're reaching opposite arm and leg. You don't have to be in full plank. You can drop those knees to the ground and still do the extension. Let's go. Opposite. Take it halfway down. Same thing. Now all the way down. And the same reach. Squeezing through the glutes. Hands next to the chest. Push it up. Take it to the other side. Sit down. All the way. Squeeze the glutes. Levitate up. Lift. Lift. Oh. We are done with side one. We're back for the cool down. Thank you for joining me in great work today. It is mandatory to cool down and stretch after a workout like that. You want to lean slightly forward and really put the weight into one leg, keeping the other straight. You should feel it through the inner thigh, a little bit in the hamstring. Now we're going to lift up and reach. While you reach, press your shoulder away from your ear. Now press that arm forward, heel of the hand, round out the back. Pull the shoulder blades apart. Now you're going to pivot over to a nice big runner's lunge. Extend that back straight leg, pressing the energy through the heels. Now I want you, if you can, drop your fingertips on the ground, try to get rid of your hump, and bring your chest forward. Drop your hips a little bit further. Now we're going to do a reversible lunge. So you're going to lift that back arm, face the back wall. Release. Walk your hands center. Keep your legs wide, feet straight. Lift a little bit so you're at a flat back, half lift. Maybe you put your hands on your shin. Maybe you can put your hands on your fingertips. Now I want you to walk your fingertips forward a little bit and really stretch through your arms. And tuck the chin under now. Walk those hands back in. I want you to take it to that other side lunge. You're staying low in the chest here. Really pressing through that inner thigh. You're gonna lift, reach, lower your shoulder. Keep that spine aligned. So don't let your head hang down. Keep it in line with the spine. Press that heel of the hand forward, round up the back. Really press it forward. Don't just put your arm out. Pivot. Low lunge. Drop your hip. Now, we're going to reach the chest forward on your fingertips. Really reach. Lengthen through that back leg. Good. Now, plant that front opposite hand with the front foot. back arm, lift, stack the shoulders, press the shoulder away, keep the head in line with the spine, strengthen the back leg. Release. We'll move you again to walk center, keeping your legs wide. You're going to plant your right hand in the middle. You may not be able to get it flat, that's okay. You're going to reach your left arm up and don't twist at the hips. Flatten your hips, twist through the middle. And reach that arm up, pressing the top shoulder back. Exhale, bring that arm down. Inhale, other side. Same cueing, keep those hips flat. Exhale, bend the knees, come up. I love the stretch. I do it almost every workout. Little twist in the middle, like you're wringing out a dirty rag. Great, let's do a little quad stretch. Did a lot of leg work today, so grab that right foot, point the knee down, tilt the pelvis, and kind of push through that pelvic bone right here. And as you flex your glutes behind, in order to do that, you will further deepen the stretch in the quadriceps. Release, other side. Get a little bend in the standing leg. Get a little bounce. Now flex the hip. Push forward. Push your foot against your hand. You want to give that stretch as much intensity as you can, just like with a workout. You don't want to be lazy in your stretching. Get it where it should be. Keep it in that lengthened position for a little bit. Okay, cross that foot over. Love this hip stretch. It's super simple. Deep breath in, exhale, not a lot of balance, not a lot of effort to this stretch. That's why I like it at the very end. Now, instead of caving like I just did, try to roll your shoulders down and back and bring your shoulder blades together. Maybe your hands don't reach all the way down, that's okay. It's gonna probably be more effective in the hip and you can kind of feel it for yourself. Okay, bend your knees and roll it up. Switch those legs. Deep breath in. Forward fold. Flat back. Or reach down. Keep breathing deeply in and out. Bend the knees. Roll it up. Take a deep breath in. Clasp those hands together. I'll show you down here. Reaching tall. Good. Now drop those arms. Twist. Hugging at the hips. And the other side. Now clasp the hands behind your back. Press them down as you push your shoulders away from your ears. Now, pull on one side and bend the neck to the opposite side, pulling the ear away from the shoulder. Switch sides. Great, now deep breath in. And exhale. Excellent work. That is no joke of a workout. Wonderful job. See you next time.